Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Inez Alea, and today it's another Tip Trick Tuesday. Alright, so in today's Tip Trick Tuesday, I will give you 3 tips to instantly make your videos look more creative and a little bit more thinking outside the box. So this is ideal for music videos or like these abstract videos. Really interesting effect that we're gonna see right now in Adobe Premiere Pro. So let's jump into it. Alright, so here we are in Adobe Premiere Pro, and what I've done is I found this video on the Pexel Video website. It's a free stock footage website where I kind of find images or videos whenever I need them, and I will drag my video only into a timeline here. So what we have is essentially an aerial video of an overtop city. Of course, the video quality isn't the best, but I didn't have time to shoot something my own. And the licensing here in Belgium for operating a drone are crazy. It's literally crazy what they're actually expecting from you as a drone operator, because you're essentially playing with a toy and you have to have the same knowledge as an actual pilot that actually operates a real airplane. So that's crazy in my opinion, but yeah, therefore I can't use a drone anymore, so, well, not as often at least. So yeah, we have this video here, and what we'll do is just instantly go to effects and search for the video effect distort, and then here we have mirror. So right here, if we apply this to our video, nothing will happen, but what you can do is play with the refraction, with the reflection center and the reflection angle. So right here, if you don't do anything, but you will play around here with the first value here, you actually bring it in here, and what you can do is just divide the initial value to 960. Well, if you divide it by 2, it gets to 960, and then you have a perfect mirrored video, and instantly that creates a much more interesting video to look at. It looks pleasing to the eye, and yeah, it just looks very attractive in my opinion, and definitely because we're working like with a symmetry kind of way, and it kind of blends in smoothly here. Of course, you can also play with the angle if you want to. You can change it to like -90, and then you have this kind of effect, which is also pretty cool. But as you can see, you can do a lot with just the mirror effect. Just play around with everything here, maybe to 180, and then you can like move it up, or this one is also pretty cool, so 180 we have here. So let's use this for now, and actually it takes the people a little second to see what's going on. Oh yeah, it's a city here, but it's kind of a kind of dreamy version of a city, which is pretty cool. Okay, so we have a black and white video. Doesn't matter if it's black or white or if it's a color video, but what you could do to make it a little bit more exciting is apply a color correction effect tint to your video, and this basically changes your video to black and white. But if you're going to play with the black and the white color, you can actually create some creative results. For example, we want to have red shadows, red dark shadows, and maybe we want to go for a yellow color here, or maybe for an orange tone, and then you get this kind of effect, which is really cool. Maybe more yellow, or you want to go for purple even, and then you get these kind of things, which is really cool. You can also go into the blue, and then you get this kind of result, which is also really exciting. Yeah, so you can really play around with everything. If you make it darker, you'll see the differences here. So I like this right here. I'm going to keep it as it is right here, and what you can do now is just play around with this. Either you apply some text to it, I'm going to choose a font, Lado, and then maybe go for a heavy font and make it white. Make it a little bit smaller and just widen it up a little bit here. Now we can jump into the window, Essential Graphics panel, if we see it right here, and we can go into edit and just center my text, and there we go. So now we have something like this, which looks immediately like I'm going to do a live set on stage, so it looks really cool. Okay, so these are two tips to instantly make your video more exciting, but I'm going to show you one more, and this one is actually really cool because you can make it even crazier by just using shapes to actually show your video. And yes, I know I'm sweating here, it's super hot in here. I have this ventilator, recently I bought this because I couldn't handle work anymore, but right now I'm recording for you guys. So unfortunately, if I would have this on, you would hear an endless buzzing, which is not fun for you guys. So that's why I'm sweating. Okay, all right, so continuing with the video, I'm just going to quickly delete the text here. And what I'll do is go for a shape. You can also import shapes. You can go in Photoshop and make triangles, which are really cool. Or you can just create a shape here, a rectangle shape. And let's create a rectangle. And you can also rotate it 45 degrees so we have a diamond, and then reposition it wherever you want, maybe in the center. And there we go, we have it nicely in the center, and we can actually use our mirror to kind of eyeball the center here, so that's also really cool. Okay, so we have our shape in the center here, and what we want to do is just make it as long as your video. So right here, we'll start and shift it over. So 5 seconds, a little bit over 5 seconds long. And now we have the shape, but what we want to do is actually bring this on the top layer. So we have our original video, hold Alt and drag it up. So we have a duplicate of that video and then the shape. Now click on the second video and go to Effect and go to Keying. So that should be right here, Keying. And we're going to use a track matte key, and this is something very known in After Effects, but if you're using Premiere Pro only, you might not have heard of this effect. But if you apply this to your video, you can use that shape as a reference to play your video through. So you can also do this with text, for example, which I'm going to show you a little bit later. But you can go over here and choose alpha matte, because we're using an alpha. But if you would have like an image where the background is black and the shape is white, you would use luma matte. So in this case, alpha matte works great. Now we're going for a matte here. We want to look at video 3, so that's where the shape is. So we want to select video 3, and there we go. Now we have that shape on that position. But of course you don't see that because the background layer is exactly the same thing. So what I'll do is lower the opacity to something like 10 or maybe 25. So you would actually still see your video, but the other video would come true, and that's just a very pleasing effect, especially for music videos or something like that. Another thing that you could do is go and apply a transform here in between these effects. So transform, that's under distort, transform. Where do I see this? I don't see it quite. Okay, here we go, distort transform, and we're going to apply that to our video here, and we're going to bring it all the way on the top here before the mirror even, and just scale it down here. So now we are scaling down our video to fit in here, and as you can see that that way you can get some more some more details in your shape. So yeah, there we have it. And of course, if you want to delete the shape, what you can do is just write something like I said. Which is what you should do, by the way, if you enjoy watching this video or my other videos. I have plenty of videos which you can go and check out. But right here we have our text, and if we're going to center this, we have now our video playing through the text. So that's really cool, in my opinion. And of course, you can disable the other layer if you want to. You can also play this on top of another video or whatever. All you're using is essentially using your video and just playing it through the top layer right here. So it can be text, it can be shapes, it can be whatever. So that's basically it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to hit the notification bell so you get notified when I upload new videos. Apart from that, definitely check out our website. We have a bunch to offer for filmmakers and motion graphics artists. And apart from that, I hope to see you in the next one. Goodbye.